Hey there, and welcome to my intro video. I am just another backyard gardener here in Ontario, Canada. Now my video camera was broken, so I had to settle with taking pictures of my garden in the beginning in order to document its progress. I'm starting over as far as gardening goes this year, and in the past I've been either too busy and things have dried out and died, or I've put in a lot of time and effort into it, and at the end of the season I had way too much food that went to waste. And that to me was a waste of effort in the end. This year I found an interest in dehydrating food, which is a great way to save food over the winter. So now I'm not afraid to get a lot of harvest, and I welcome it. So welcome to my journey, and I hope you enjoy following along as I go. I started everything except our beefsteak tomatoes by seed, and these are all heirloom seed varieties that I purchased here in Ontario. Okay, so this is where our original garden area was. That was before we planted trees, which have now shaded the entire area. Here we have zucchini. It's a bush variety. It will not grow out like a vine. And then I have butternut squash. This ground is very dry and it's clay soil, so it's not the best for growing. Okay, I planted four rows of beans this year. Two of them came up and one I had to replant after a couple of weeks. Peas are on the left, they were a good spring crop, and they're done now. Bush beans, they don't usually make it to the kitchen, we usually munch as we weed. This little green pepper is the size of a nickel and a very small plant also. Beefsteak tomatoes are really short. I'm comparing them to the size of a soap bottle. I planted these sideways in the ground to get good roots, however the rabbits enjoyed the plant tops and we had a hard time getting them to grow. Lots of seedlings and not enough containers, so I bought topsoil with compost in bags and I planted them right in the bags, three per bag. Some here up against the shed, we get the afternoon sun. Some by the house get the morning sun. Green peppers in the window box container, they're too shallow or they require deeper pots. It might be okay for lettuce next year. Okay, here's some containers with lettuce. I just sprinkled the seeds right in these pots. One is leaf lettuce and the one on the right is butter crunch. Okay, the watermelon plants finally starting to grow. I had to reseed a couple of times right in the pot. I think I went through around a dozen seeds between trying to seed them inside and outside. My cabbage and broccoli were eaten. Within 2 days, the little green worms, caterpillars, cutworms, whatever you want to call them, they stripped the leaves bare right down to nothing. I should have sprayed them earlier, but I waited too long. At the end of this video, please see my neem oil solution. Zucchini plants in a container. Cherry, grape, tomatoes, and some pickling cucumbers. These pole beans are a week old. They're in a big tub with two sunflowers in the center. The little bunnies down there just got a bath, so. Some of the containers are up high off the ground. Okay, let's talk about tomato blossom rot. Okay, so tomato blossom end rot. This is from, first of all, not having enough calcium. The plant's going from really dry to really wet soil. And because the low calcium level, they cannot keep up with the rapid growth spurts. And this is what happens, blossom end rot. I added lime to my soil and it didn't help. So I tried adding a couple of tablets of Tums to the water reservoirs and it seems to be working. Okay, we're going to switch over now. This is a week later. A week later, after spraying the neem solution, the cabbage has new growth in the center. These are before and after pictures, okay? The broccoli has new center leaf growth, and these are before and after pictures. New growth here in the center. Okay, and the pole beans 1 week later. Here's before and after with the sunflowers in the middle. Okay, and then after a month with no rain, we finally get rain, but it comes with damaging winds around 3 o'clock in the morning. This branch covered 6 of my tomato plants. They're damaged, but they will survive. There's some zucchini growing in the garden. And over here in the compost pile, we found some tomato plants growing. So last year's garbage became this year's feast. Please support my videos by subscribing. As long as there's interest, I will continue to post. Thanks for watching.